Hi guys. So I'm here in the shop today and I'm just testing to see if the new microphone that I've got to try and make the sound better for you is working. If you're on here, can you hear me? Waiting to hear whether Rosie can hear me as well. Oh, we're getting thumbs up. We can hear. Okay. Hopefully, guys, that sound is a lot better for you because unfortunately we can't stop working today in the shop. We've got to have things going on around. So I've tried to create a little haven, a little corner to do this sew along in. But there is undoubtedly going to be a bit of background noise. But hopefully the microphone will be making that better. So it's just focusing on me rather than all the other noises. So hello, hello, hello. We are here to do the sew along for the makeup and toiletries bag. I'm very excited to do a nice easy project with you today. Hi Joanna, hi Helene, thank you for joining. Hi Sarah. So like I said, I'm here in the shop. It's kind of, if you follow me on Lisa Comfort Home, you'll see that we are in the middle of a very big photo shoot for Lisa Comfort Home, photographing all the wonderful things that we've been working on. And so I've got some of them behind me. We've actually got, we'll be launching candles. I've got one here trying to keep me zen. Also, because it has been such a monster week, look what I have, look what I've been given to keep me going. Lisa's very own teacup of goodies. I've got peanut M&Ms in there, I've got Haribo, I've got chocolate. So I'll be munching on those as we go. I've also got a cup of tea, of course, a nice strong cup of tea. So where are people tuning in from today, guys? Oh, I can see some names, I know where you guys are from. Thank you for joining. Hi, Sal. Where's everyone from? Let's see how international we are today. Always love seeing that. Or how national. Have we got a good spread of the UK with us today? Let's have a look. Sunny Bournemouth. Yeah, it is sunny. Well, it was sunnier here earlier. London. Another fellow Londoner. Hi there. London doesn't seem that quiet today, even though I thought it would be, does it? A newbie from Plymouth. Oh, thank you, Denise, for joining us. That's great. Welcome to the sew-alongs. Oxfordshire, Bath, Dorset, Devon, oh, Luton, Hertfordshire. Oh, we've got a good UK spread today. Not yet had many from the north, near northerners. Muddy West Sussex, oh dear. Liverpool, there we go, the north, yay. I'm bringing it in internationally. Nicole's tuning in from Germany. Nina from Liverpool, Hampshire. Love doing this, it's so great. It's so exciting seeing all those places. Virginia, woohoo. Czech Republic, hello. Oh, Sarah, you're bringing it more international with your friend from Italy. Buongiorno. Oh, and Pauline, you're still in Spain. Oh, I hope you're enjoying some sunshine. And we've got some, and Sal is joining us from Sydney. Or just south of Sydney in Australia. Port Elizabeth in South Africa. Hi, Charlene. Oh, wow. Right, guys. Keep telling us all where you are. It's all lovely to see for everybody. So we've got Rosie joining us, answering your questions as usual. So if you have any sewing questions, even if they're not related to what we're doing today, you can just ask away. You've got the opportunity to have live access to Rosie to answer your sewing questions. So what we're hoping in doing an easier project like this every week is that we're going to be encouraging more beginners to be sewing with us on the sew-alongs, and also for those of us who sew lots, we want to give you some sort of light-hearted, easy sewing so it's not all too intense. So I've been really looking forward to making this today. I tell you what, you can't have enough of these makeup bags, especially if you're like me, you're a bit of a skincare and makeup junkie and like having all your makeup in different bags and things. So yeah, that's what we're going to do. So I've got my fabric here. Da, 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 da. And I've all got my zip. And what else? I've got my sweets and chocolate, not necessary for this. I've got an incredibly narrow little console table that I'm doing this on today, guys. So I can't really give you a better angle from this. But anyway, here, this is what we've got. So I'm going to dive straight in and let's just start talking about what we need to do first. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our two pieces and we are going to place them right sides together. Sizes of fabric. Well, Anne, that's a good question because it actually doesn't really matter. So basically, you can make this as big or as small as you want. It's completely dependent on what you want. So you can make a nice little smaller one. Main thing is the length of the zip has to sit. If you buy the zip as long as the bag is going to be, you're not going to use it the full length across there, so as wide as the bag will be. But that will mean you've definitely got a long enough zip. So I believe Rosie put this little wonderful kit together for me. Rosie, is this a 16 inch? Maybe not 16 inches, actually. Don't be lazy, Lisa. You've got a tape measure here. Let's measure it. No, 12. 12 inch. I did think that was a bit short for that. Yes, you're right, Rosie. So yes, guys, it doesn't matter. Now, Rosie, I know we were going to be planning on releasing this as a little product. Is that live yet, or I have to ask you before? Yeah, woohoo! You judged that correctly. Because I know we are adding some little beginner projects. We've also got our drawstring bag there from last week that you can now download as a pattern. Is this one up there as well, Rosie? Let's wait and see what Rosie says. I don't need that. I don't know why I've got that there. Oh, hi, Sarah. Happy Friday. Oh, that's lovely to hear, Lorianne. No, we're not ready yet, but yeah, that's fair. That's fair enough. We've all been incredibly busy, both so over at Lisa Comfort Home team, that's fine, Rosie. But just so you guys know, if you are watching this, hi, Kim. If you are watching this and you're a newbie and you want us to have the pattern and all the instructions for this, that will be up early next week. Okay, so what we're going to do first is we're going to work out where we're going to put our zip. So I've got my piece here, and what I like to do is I put a pin in front of the zip pull there, like that, and then I'm going to get that, so it's about 5 centimeters from the edge. Now, if you are making a much smaller bag, you probably want to do about half of that, 2.5 centimeters. So, let's get my tape measure. Did I have that? Where did I put it? It's down here. Okay. Oh, lots of happy Fridays, guys. Who's glad it's the weekend? I am. I plan on staying in my pajamas most of the weekend. I'm exhausted. Okay, so there's a problem with my tape measure. It's got a sticker right in the place where I needed to see. So I'm going to use the other end, but I'm basically going to measure 5 centimeters from the raw edge. So from this edge here in. Okay. And then I'm going to move my pin to that point. So that's it. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it into the fabric. Okay. And then I'm going to measure 5 centimeters from the other end. So those of you that like to work in imperial, I keep having to, this 5 centimeters is 2 inches. Okay. There we go. Popping that in. Okay. Guys, I'm sorry, I'm going to have to be really rude now to the team taking photos. Sorry, when you're talking, I don't know if it's picking up in here, but it's just distracting me a little bit. Sorry. Meow. I'm getting a aye aye, Captain. So we are now going to snip into that. So we've got a notch, which is essentially a snip into the fabric through the zip tape and also through both layers of fabric. Now, ideally you want to be using scissors that are nice and sharp. I think mine have got a bit of glue on the end, so they're getting a bit stuck. But I've snipped in here. I've snipped into the zip tape and I've snipped into the fabric. And I've done that at both points where those pins were. So then you can take that off. Put that there. And then we're going to pin this edge. So the edge that we have just snipped into, we're going to pin that together. So there's lots of ways of putting zips in, and this is just one of many, and I love this way of putting a regular zip in, because what we're going to do is we're going to stitch the seam closed So the section of the seam where the zip will be, which will be inside these two notches, that's going to be stitched with a big stitch, with a machine tacking stitch, so it's easy to unpick. And then the other bits will be stitched with a regular stitch length. And then once we've stitched the zip in, we'll be able to unpick it. So it'll all become clear as we're sewing, guys, at the end. But this is the technique we're going to be using today. So over to our sewing machines already. We're just going to be working with a straight stitch. And we're going to be using the seam allowance of 1.5. So I am sitting on this very low armchair in the shop. So excuse that I'm struggling to kind of see up there. But so it was the easiest way of us quickly setting up a sewing area for me today. So we're going to start at the top here and we're going to sew up to the snip or the notch using a regular seam stitch length. Seam allowance is 1.5 or 5/8 of an inch. Make sure you do a nice reverse at the beginning and then continue up to the notch. Do a little reverse and back and then we're going to stop. I'm going to have a sip of tea. And then we're going to increase our stitch length. Okay, and then along we go. Sew along. Yes, guys, Coco, I need to tell you all about Coco. She's come back. I'm going to tell you about this after I've done this, when I'm doing my ironing. Thank you, guys. Thank you. So we're level now with the next notch. So then we're going to move it back to our normal stitch length. And then we're going to go forwards, 2-3 stitches, backwards, forwards. So we're making sure we're reversing at that point where the notch is so that we're securing that part of the seam and then all the way to the end and then we're reversing again. Okay. So I'm going to trim those bits off and then we're going to press the seam open. Now I'm going to tell you about Coco. So basically what happened, I saw you guys on Tuesday when she'd been missing and I basically, after I finished filming for Stitch School, jumped in the car, picked up Jazzy from nursery and we went back to the cottage and Coco had been, I basically put it up on a Facebook group and everything and there had been a reported sighting of her in our front garden of the cottage, which I'm very rarely in, or you know, we don't really go in that part, but anyway, she was there. And she basically had, she'd found her way back, but she had most definitely got stuck or lost because she came back. I'm so glad that when I got back there, I couldn't see her, but I just called and she came running. And the poor little thing, she actually came up to me first and sniffed my hand to see if she knew me. And then, yeah, but she clearly hadn't eaten in the 4 days that she'd been missing. She was so thin and really shaky. She then proceeded to eat 3 big full bowls of food. And then I just was like literally stuck to her all night and she's just slept. She's still sleeping an insane amount because we were doing a photo shoot there and she slept most of the day. So she's just been catching up. But anyway, it's so nice to have her back. And I have to say, it was very hard to I kept her in for about a day and a half, 2 days, and now I've let her out, but she's been going out and in and out. Yesterday I let her out and we were there and she was coming back, so I'm hoping all will be fine when I get back there today. Right, so we're pressing open the seam there, but yeah, that was the best news of the week, Coco returning. So relieved. So that's our seam pressed open. Thank you guys for all your lovely words there. And now what we're going to do is we're going to take the zip, so that's the front of the zip, and we're going to place it face down onto the seam allowance. And then we've got our little snippy bits to help us line up. So we've got our notches that we did. And so the notch on the zip needs to line up with the notch on the seam allowance there. And then I'm going to do the same there. So the notch on the zip tape has to line up with the notch on the seam allowance. And we're putting our pins in horizontally. So they're going across. And they're going through the zip tape. And they're going through the seam allowance. like that. Okay? It's really important that there's a pin exactly where the notches are at the top and at the bottom of the zip. So then what we're going to do is turn it to the right side, and we're going to pin from this side. So if you turn it so that you've got the chunky bit, the zip pull at the top there, and if we all start on the left and we pin up towards that horizontal pin. Okay. So each pin needs to touch the next one, but not overlapping. That's what we're aiming for. So what we're going to do is we're going to put them up on this side, and then we're going to put them down on the other side so that they're in the right position for the direction that we're going to be sewing the zip in. So now we're at the other side, so I'm going to put them in the opposite direction. So if you turn it and then you put them going the other way. Now, I was hoping today, guys, to be able to talk to you about this, what we've been mentioning about having some kind of sew-along for making these for our local women's refuge, but we haven't had a chance to talk about it. So I won't be able to talk about that today. It's just been too busy this week, but we are planning on telling you about that. That's definitely something we want to do. It probably will be early December, but we'll... Well, morning, Teresa. It will be, just watch this space. We will talk about it, but I just haven't had the time to do anything this week other than the photo shoots and stuff. So sorry that I wasn't able to talk about that, but it's definitely something we all want to do here. So yeah, watch this space. So the next thing we need to do is we need to take out these horizontal pins that mark where the notches are at either end. So what I'm going to do is I'm putting my thumb over where the pin is. I'm going to take it out, but my thumb's showing me where it was, and then I'm going to put it back in from the right side. Okay? And then the same down here. So taking it out and putting it back in. And then we're going to remove the pins from the back. So now there are no pins on the back, and all the pins are on the front. And it looks like that. Just check, because I need to see there, that I haven't got that part of the zip tape caught in. It's just sort of pushed out. So let's just show you again. That's the back of the zip. We first pinned that horizontally just to get the position of the zip right on top of the seam allowance, and the zip teeth need to be sitting centrally right on top of the middle of the seam there. Okay, and then we turn it to this side, you'll see all my pins in there. So you'll see there's a horizontal pin at the top and also at the bottom. And then there's also parallel pins going up on one side and down on the other. So the zip is really in a good, strong position. It's not moving anywhere. If you wanted to, you could put a nice big hand stitching in now and you that hand tack it, but I don't think it's necessary. But of course, if that's what you want to do, by all means do. But we're going to go straight in and we're just going to stitch it in on the machine, and we're going to use a zip foot. So for any beginners, that's what a zip foot looks like. It's different from a regular foot in that it doesn't have the edges on it at the sides. If we look at a regular, you can see there's kind of bits either side, and if you look at this, it's missing. So those bits there missing mean that we can get nice and close to the zip teeth, and it doesn't push you over too far. Because if you try and stitch a zip in with a regular foot, it pushes you so far away from the zip teeth, you often end up missing the zip tape because the zip teeth get in the way. So that's what this does. So you can choose on this my machine to put it on the left or onto the right. It's completely up to you. Or some zip feet have a single arm and you move the needle either side. So it depends on your make. But my machine has this, certainly the machine that I'm using today. I'm using a real selection of machines on these sew-alongs, haven't I, recently, depending on where I am. And then I am just going to line up at the top. So I'm going to start at the end. I don't know if you can see. If I put it back a bit, maybe you can see a little bit more clearly. I'm going to start where the horizontal zip meets the vertical zip, like that. lower my pin in. I'm going to take that horizontal pin out. So I lowered my needle in. I know that I'm at least about 5 millimeters from the middle of the seam, which will mean that I'm going to stitch through the tape, but obviously not going to hit those zip teeth. I want to make sure that I will get past that really thick part of the zip where the zip pull is, and then that determines the width. That's why we start at this side of the bag and not at the bottom of the zip, because if we started at the bottom of the zip, we wouldn't have that really thick chunky piece to get past, and therefore you might start too narrow and you then get up to that piece and then you have to go like this and you end up with stitch lines like that. So what we need to do is get to the chunky bit, start there, know that we can get back past that, and then we keep our stitching parallel. If you wanted to, you could use a fabric marker and you could draw in your stitch line, because what we're going to do now is essentially come down, come across, come up, and come across again. So we're going to do it in a nice big rectangle. Right guys, let's start. I'm going to do a little reverse, and then away I go. I've just realised I don't have a zip unpicker, so if anyone here in the shop can hear me and knows if there's a zip unpicker here, it'd be good if I could have one, not a zip unpicker, a seam unpicker. And then we're going to just take those pins out as we get to them. So if you haven't drawn yourself a pen line, you're just going to have to use your eye to keep your stitch line straight. And so what I'm looking at is the flat edge of the zip foot there and the central seam on my bag, which is stitch closed. Try and keep your fabric taut. Take that, that's just moved. We're keeping the fabric taut because we don't want to get any little pleats in there. That's fine. Now I'm going to put the needle in, and then so I'm putting the needle in. We've got some little snips, we'll try those. Thank you. Got those for later, you'll see in a second. So I've got down to the second horizontal pin, taken that out, and I put my needle in. Okay, lift up, pivot round, and then we're going to stitch across. I know, guys, it's hard that you can't see lots of close-ups of this, but if you are interested in really seeing this more clearly in terms of camera angles and also taking it a little bit slower, then you could sign up to our Intro to Sewing on Stitch School, because this is one of the projects we do on that. Thought I'd just mention that. I think Rosie did earlier, but I didn't get a chance to say it. So now we've pivoted, so a needle went in, we've turned it, and we're coming across the bottom of the zip. Needle in, I've now stopped, I've come across the zip, I'm now on the other side of the zip, and I'm making sure that I'm about the same distance where I stopped on that side. So needle is in, I'm pivoting again. So far we've gone down one side and we've gone across the bottom, and that's where we are now. So now we're going to come up the other side, keeping that stitching as parallel as we can, and taking your pins out as you get to them. So what you hopefully will be finding is that pins are so much easier to take out because the head is facing you, so you can just whip it out before you get to it. You don't need to. It's not awkward. If the pin head was the other way, then it would be like, you'd be like that. This were getting in the way, it'd be really awkward. So that's why we did the pins in the direction that we did. So I'm coming up to the top now. And I'm level with where I started. So needle going in, presser foot coming up, and then we're pivoting again, and we're going to stitch across. Meeting where we were, and then a nice little reverse across the top, so that's secure. Okay, I can now take that out. I think I meant to put these over. Always think though, if you put these over, it's a bit of a visual. If you accidentally bend down too much, you probably get stabbed. Anyway, knowing me, guys, you know what I'm like. It's probably not wise for me to have them around my neck. I have to say, they are really nice. Anyone else wear these around their neck when they're sewing? So, I'm going to show you what that looks like. Can you see? It's like a rectangle across the bottom, across those parallel stitching. And now comes the very exciting bit. Now what we're going to do is we're going to unpick the seam in the middle. And normally you want to use a seam unripper for this, but I don't have one of those. So instead, I'm going to use these snips. I'm going to just snip the first bit. And then I'm going to snip a bit more. Now I'm using the Lisa Comfort Home monochrome palms fabric, which came out only a week ago, or a few days ago, and it's the perfect weight for this. So it's really is, you know, going to make a really lovely bag, toiletry bag, but also it means that I don't have to be too careful when I'm unpicking. I'm finding that I'm sort of like this. I'm going to take that off. So if you are unpicking with a lighter weight fabric, you need to just be careful that you're not catching the fabric at the same time. And in terms of fabric types that you could use, you want to be making something out of this out of cotton. And nothing too... Oh, Denise is just saying how you got your mini scissors on your table. We've basically decided I need a mobile sew-along bag that I just have with me all the time. That's maybe what I should use this bag for, isn't it? Yes. Oh, that's lovely, Teresa. Yeah, I could use this as my sewing equipment bag that I keep with me at all times, so that I always have everything I need wherever I am. So, there we go. I've done it. We need to pull those little bits out now, but I've basically unpicked the seam that was in the middle where the zip was. And this is a very exciting thing that happens now. Da 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 da. Oh, it's the top you're wearing on, it's not the tabletop. Sorry Denise, I read it too quickly. Look, da da, there it is. There is our zip. And what's so perfect about this technique is that it means that it's beautifully concealed. So, what chocolate do I have? Well, let me tell you. I've got some Galaxy chocolate. I've got chocolate peanut M&Ms. And I've also got Haribos. I'm sugared up to the max, guys. I'll be buzzing all afternoon and then crashing. Crashing with a third, probably. So, I'm just taking those little bits out. You can obviously continue to take them out. I'm being offered more. I've got loads. I've got enough here. Hopefully I won't get through all of that before. Okay. So we're going to open that. Now we've done that. And now we're going to turn it into a bag. So in order to do that, we're going to have to cut off this extra little bit because we don't need that. I'm just going to use the big scissors for that. That's just going to get in the way. So I'm going to cut that off. And then placing it right sides together like that. Oh, have you? Oh, that's a good idea, recovering dining chairs. We're going to place it, fold it right sides together like this. I'm going to make sure that the seam is right on the edge there. And then we're going to pin. Okay. And then we're going to pin all of these edges together. So we're coming down one side, we're going to go across the bottom and up there, lining up your raw edges. The next stage will be sewing these together, so that's why we're doing this. How are we doing for time, guys? Oh, we've got plenty. We're doing fine. Oh, it's a crisp day today in the shop, guys. The problem with our shop is that it's boiling in the summer because it's lots of glass windows, and in the winter it's freezing. Deirdre, I won't be lining the bag because I won't have time to, but if you wanted to line the bag, you could just make the whole bag again separately, obviously without the zip in. So what you do is you don't do that middle section, Yep, the zip is open. Yep, I've left the zip open because we're going to sew it all closed and then we're going to turn it through. But yes, Deirdre, what you could do is you could make the another lining piece by just stitching the whole bag but leaving the gap at the top, and then you can slip stitch it onto the back of the zip. But we won't have time to do that today. But if you're using it a nice canvas fabric, then you don't need to. That should be enough. Okay, so there we have it stitched together. So let's now, not stitch together, pin together. Let's now stitch it together. So let's put our zip foot, regular zip feet back on the machines. Our seam allowance is 1.5 centimetres or 5/8 of an inch. So we're going to stick to that. Okay. Right, starting at the top right-hand side of the bag. Take that pin out. Make sure you do a nice reverse to secure your start of your seam. And then away you go. Okay, needle in, pivot across. So when we come to pivot at this first corner, what we're doing is we are stopping 1.5 centimetres from the bottom edge here. So you've got to judge that by eye. If you get it wrong, if you kind of don't do it enough, then you'll know when you put your needle in, you come back round, and if you're not lined up with your 1.5 or 5/8 marker here, you'll know you've not gone enough, or you need to go back a bit and do a little bit less. So if you've not gone enough, you can just pull it back, drop it down, and then just do another stitch or whatever you need. And you can use the hand wheel to do a stitch at a time, or you can always just reverse back and then pivot from there. So we're just going to turn that back. Okay. And we're going to come up the other side. Pivot! Sorry guys, Fiona, I'm now, those of you that watched the Sew Along where we were shouting about Ross from Friends saying pivot when he was going, trying to get a sofa up into his flat. Yep, we just keep hearing Ross shouting pivot. So I'm coming up to the next corner, and before I put my needle in, I'm just checking that I'm seeing 1.5 centimetres again. Needle goes in, lift up, turn round, and down we come. Okay, there we go. So we have now essentially created a bag. Oh, that's very kind of you to say, Sal. Pivot, classy. we've created a bag, guys, but we're going to do better than this. We're going to create some shaping in it at the bottom. So we're not going to stop yet. But what we're going to do first, we're going to cut off our corners. So when you go to cut off a corner, the reason why you do that is when you turn it through, if you've got all this fabric here trying to fit into the smaller space here, you won't get a nice point. But we need to make sure that we don't cut through the stitching. So put your thumb over the stitching. Oh gosh, sorry guys, we've started a trend now of Ross from Friends and pivots. Pivot! So I've cut those off, and that now means that will make a nice point. But we do need to stop all these edges from fraying. So if you've got an overlocker, you could whiz along with the overlocker. I haven't got one here with me today because I wanted to make this as easy as possible for everybody, even if you don't have that. You're right, Deirdre, a bright pink zip would have been lovely. I love a bit of hot pink and black and white. Always think it was really nice. So we're going to put it up the machine onto a zigzag, and I'm going to have it on stitch length about 2.5, and I'm going the full width, which is stitch width 5. Now when you're doing a zigzag, what we're doing is we're concentrating on the edge of the fabric and we are stopping it from fraying. So the machine goes from left to right doing the zigzag like this. When it goes to the right, you want it to be just hitting off the edge so that the machine stitching binds around that edge and therefore stops it from fraying any further. So we're just coming round those diagonal corners. If you wanted to, you could have pivoted at the diagonal corners. I've chosen just to, I'm just, in the interest of time, I'm just gonna try and do it all continuously. The settings, Deirdre, were stitch width 5 and stitch length 2.5. I think when you're doing a zigzag for this purpose, the wider the better. Especially if it's a nice canvas fabric. Okay, oh gosh, I've gone too far with that now. Okay. Reversing at the end, sorry guys, I was so focused. I was like, oh, there's a comment on there, I completely came off. I don't make underwear, no, Jude, but you know, never say never. At the moment, I don't know how I would have time to do that, but I have always thought it'd be a nice thing to do. Right, I'm now just trimming off those little bits that were already kind of frayed from before, just to neaten that up. Nothing will fray anymore now that we've done our zigzagging. I'm going to try and show you a bit up close so you can see. Yeah? Okay. I didn't show you guys, but I'm actually wearing the Heidi dress today. It's my perfect favourite winter dress to wear, actually, or one of. A wrap dress, of course. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to box these corners so that we create some shaping at the bottom of the bag and it will help the bag sit upright. So what you need to do is put your hand inside and you want to pull out the front and the back, like that. Okay? Beautiful. And then we're gonna put a pin in to the seam from this side, so right into the seam. Thanks, Lorianne. And then we're coming out the other side. So I'm making sure that my pin, it goes into the seam on that side and it comes out that side, okay? And then we're just gonna put that pin through so it holds it. Okay, we'll do the same again. So it starts like that. You're gonna separate it out like that to create this triangle shape. Pull the front and the back out. And then you're putting the needle into the seam, sorry, the pin into the seam so it comes out the other side and then closing that off like that. There we go. They do box corners, that's what we're doing. Oh, thank you guys. Yeah, it's gorgeous, this fabric. This was just a sample fabric that I wouldn't be able to find again, but I can't even remember where I got it from, but yeah, I do love it. So now, what I need, normally I have a ruler to do this, but I don't have a ruler. I could do with a pen though. Could somebody pass me a pen, please? Sorry, not very prepared today, guys. Doesn't matter what kind of pen or a pencil, thank you. I'm going to be a bit naughty, guys, and use a biro because that's all I've got. Right, what we're going to do is we're going to measure 5 centimetres from the tip there to where we're to down. So from the tip of the little triangle, we're going to measure 5 centimetres and then put a little mark there. So 5 centimetres is 2 inches. So I measured from here to there. Okay. And then the same on the other side. Okay, so then if you have a ruler, what you want to do is draw a nice straight line across there. I haven't got a ruler, so I'm going to use my tape measure to try and do it. So keeping it straight so that your line will be perpendicular with that stitch line, so it'll create a right angle with that stitch line there. Okay. And then the same here. Oops. Yeah, Rosie, maybe you could put a link up for the Heidi dress. I know it's only available in the magazine. We are working on releasing all these magazine patterns as So Over It patterns, guys, so bear with me. I'm laughing at your jokes, Sal. Okay, there we go. Right, so we are not, we're now going to machine this along this line. So I'm going to go back to a straight stitch. I'm going to feed that pen line in the middle of my on the middle of my presser foot. So I'm going to do a nice little reverse and then make sure that these seams are pressed to one side. Okay, I've just stitched across that. And then we're going to do the same on this one. This is when it seems scary, guys, but we're going to do it. We are going to cut across here. Now, obviously, main short thing, we're going to cut this side of the seam. We're going to cut it, so we're leaving ourselves a centimetre seam allowance. I'm going to do that on that side. And then I'm going to do it over here. I used to teach this. This was a makeup bag that I designed the little pattern for right at the beginning when I opened So Over It, and I used to teach beginners, and I did all the teaching myself then, and every time that I used to teach this class, I used to teach people this particular section, they always would be like, oh, when they saw me cut through it. So it seems like you're ruining your bag, but you're not. You're getting rid of stuff that you don't need. Then that little seam that we've now created, we just need to zigzag that one. So that we can, so that we can make sure those edges don't fray either. Just exactly the same as what we did on the other seams. Just finishing that so it's a nice finished edge. There's no raw frayed bits. And then we're just going to tidy up before the big reveal. Da, 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 da. We didn't do any pressing along the way because we sort of made a few shortcuts there, but we're going to do a bit of a press now. I'm just making sure that all my loose ends have been trimmed. I'm also going to cut off, well, I can't actually, I should have maybe done a bit, cut off a bit of this perhaps earlier, but it's difficult because if you cut here and then you've got to overlay, you do make it quite weak because it's quite close to where the stitching is, but you can cut it off. Anyway, it just makes it means you get a nicer point when we turn it through. But let's turn it through, guys. Drum roll. We've got a drum roll there. Da, 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 da. Okay, we're pushing through the corners there. We're pushing this up. Actually, it doesn't look like it needs a press. You could go ahead and press these, but I think it's actually fine. I'm just going to use the scissors to just, because it's quite strong fabric, I can use the scissors just to force through that corner a little bit more. There we have it, guys. A makeup bag, toiletry bag, whatever you want to do. Perfect for gifts, such a nice thing for Christmas presents, this. I tell you, my family is sick of them. They don't want them anymore. Although I haven't given them one in a few years. Maybe it's time to revise this gift. I could give them the option of a drawstring bag or this. I've peaked too early. I've been giving them pussy bow blouses and all sorts of things. Now they're like, if it's not a jacket or a coat, Lisa, we don't want it. No, they're not really like that. But I don't think I have time to make a jacket or a coat for them. So this year, maybe one of these. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed that. I hope you were able to follow along as well. I know I did it quite quickly, as I often do. You do not need to sew at the pace that I sew at, but it means that I fit more in and cover more ground so that you can see more of the project. That's why I try and go as quickly as I do. But remember that you can always watch it again, and it will just go after this. It just depends on how fast the internet is wherever I am, but it then gets uploaded. The Heidi's available up to size 20 at the moment, I believe. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for joining me. I'm back next week, of course. I'm going to be here every week, as we've said, from now on, so 3 times a week. So next week I'll be back on Monday doing the Thea dress, I believe. Although maybe, Rosie, you can tell me what I'm doing because I can't remember. But I'm back on Monday at 1 o'clock. I think I'm then back at 1 o'clock on Tuesday, and then Thea on Monday it is, yay. And then I'm also back on another day, but I can't remember. I think I'm back at doing an evening. Oh, it's the Georgie on Tuesday, wonderful. Oh, we love the Georgie dress. So yeah, there's lots of lovely sew alongness. There's a link to it in the description box, guys. Face covering, that's what it is. We're going to do face coverings or masks together on Wednesday evening. So, guys, I will see you all for that. Hope you all have lovely weekends. Look after yourselves, rest. Enjoy the weekend. And I'll see you all for more sewing fun on Monday. Bye.